Good morning, students. In the previous session, we discussed about some problems related to arithmetic progression. So we know the formula to find out nth term of the sequence AP is Tn is equal to A plus n minus 1 into D. So sum of first n terms of the series in AP is denoted by Sn, defined as n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d, or n by 2 into a plus c n, here a means first term of the sequence. So d means common difference between any term and its previous term, so d is called common difference. So n represent number of terms in the sequence. So tn means nth term of the sequence. Sn means sum of first n terms of the sequence. So today we are going to discuss some problems related to arithmetic progression. So first problem, find the three numbers which are in AP. Whose sum is 12. And the sum of their cubes. Sum of their cubes is 408. Okay, so here we want to find out three numbers which are in AP. So first let us assume that required three numbers to be, it is in the form of A minus D, A plus D. So let A minus D, A plus D be the required three numbers in AP. So next, write the given data. So given that, so sum of these three numbers is 12. So therefore, A minus D plus A plus A plus D is equal to 12. So first simplify this equation. So minus D plus D, so get cancels. A plus A plus A, 3A is equal to 12. A is equal to 12 by 3. So therefore A is equal to 4. So here we want to find out these three numbers, means here we require values of A and D. So here we get A is equal to 4. Next let us find the value of D. So using the one more condition, so given that one more condition, sum of their cubes, so means sum of the cubes of these numbers is 408. So cubes of this number, sum of cubes of this number, so consider A minus D whole cube plus A cube plus A plus D whole cube. Sum of cubes of these three numbers is equal to 408. By solving this equation, let us find the value of D. So first simplify. So here expand A minus D whole cube by applying A minus B whole cube formula. So A minus B whole cube is A cube minus B cube minus 3AB into A minus B. So here A minus D whole cube can be written as A cube minus D cube minus 3AD into A minus D. So plus A cube plus, here apply A plus B whole cube formula. So A cube plus D cube plus 3AD into A plus D is equal to 408. Next simplify here. minus d cube plus d cube get cancels. So a cube plus a cube plus a cube. So 3 a cube. Next multiply minus 3ad into a minus 3 a square into d. So minus into minus plus 3 ad into d a d square. So plus here multiply this term by 3ad. So 3ad into a 3 a square d plus 3ad into d. So 3 a d square is equal to 408. Okay, next minus 3 a square d plus 3 a square d get cancels. So 3 a cube. So here substitute a means 4. So 4 cube. 3 a d square plus 3 a d square. So plus 6 a d square is equal to 408. Next simplify 3 into 4 cube. 4 cube is 64 plus 6 into a means 4 into d square is equal to 408. So 3 into 64 192 plus 6 into 4 into d 6 into 4 24 d square is equal to 408. Simplify. Therefore 24 d square is equal to 408. Take this term into right side, becomes minus 192. Therefore 24 d square is equal to 408 minus 192 is 216. Therefore d square is equal to 216 divided by 24. Therefore d square is equal to 216 divided by 24 is 9. Therefore d is equal to root 9. So root 9 means plus or minus 3. D is equal to plus or minus 3. So therefore required 3 numbers. Required 3 numbers means a minus d, a plus d. Therefore required 3 numbers in AP are, so first consider A is 4, D is equal to plus 3. So therefore required numbers are A minus D, A plus D. So A means 4 minus D means 3. So 4 minus 3, 1. So A means 4. So A 4 plus D means 3. 4 plus 3, 7. So therefore required numbers are 1, 4, 7. So next consider D is equal to minus 3. A is 4, D is minus 3. Therefore required numbers are A minus D, A plus D. So A means 4 minus D. D means minus 3. So minus of minus 3 plus 3. So 4 plus 3, 7. So A means 4. 4 plus D means minus 3. So plus of minus 3, minus 3. 4 minus 3, 1. So 7, 4, 1 are 1, 4, 7. Therefore required 3 numbers in AP are 1, 4, 7. Okay. So next let us move on to next problem. Next problem, find the 4 numbers in AP. Find the 4 numbers in AP whose sum is whose sum is 20 and the product of whose extremes and the product of whose extremes is 16. So here, using these two conditions, here we want to find out four numbers in AP. So first let us assume that required four numbers, it is in the form of A minus 3D, so A minus D, A plus D and A plus 3D. So these four are the required numbers. Here we want to find out these three numbers, these four numbers means first let us find the values of A and D using the given conditions. So assume that let A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D, A plus 3D be the required four numbers. Required four numbers in AP. Next write the given conditions. So given that sum of four numbers is 20. So sum of these four numbers is 20. So A minus 3D plus A minus D plus A plus D plus A plus 3D is equal to 20. Okay, next simplify here. Minus 3D plus 3D get cancels. Minus D plus D get cancels. So A plus A plus A plus A. So 4A. 4A is equal to 20. Therefore, A is equal to 20 by 4. Therefore, A is equal to 5. Now, consider next condition. So, given that the product of whose extremes, extremes means end numbers. So, end numbers means A minus 3D and A plus 3D. So, product of these two numbers is 16. So, means so A minus 3D into A plus 3D is equal to 16. So, by solving this equation, let us find the value of D. So, first here apply A minus B into A minus B formula. So, we know that A plus B into A minus B is A square minus B square. So, here A square minus 3D whole square is equal to 16. So, here substitute A. A means 5. So, 5 square minus 3 square means 9. 9 into D square is equal to 16. So, 5 square means 25 minus 9 into D square is equal to 16. Take this term into right side becomes plus 9D square. Take 16 into left side becomes minus 16. 25 minus 16 is equal to 9D square. 25 minus 16 is 9. Is equal to 9D square. Therefore, D square is equal to 9 by 9. Therefore, D square is equal to 1. So, D is equal to root 1 means plus or minus 1. D is equal to plus or minus 1. Now, therefore, required 4 numbers are 4 numbers are A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D, A plus 3D. So A means 5. So 5 minus 3 into, so first consider d means plus 1. So d 1. So here a means 5, d means 1. Here 5 minus 3, 2. Here 5 minus 1, 4. Here a means 5, d means plus 1. So 5 plus 1, 6. A means 5. So 3 into d means 1. So 5 plus 3, 8. Therefore, required 4 numbers are 2, 4, 6, 8. Suppose if we consider d is equal to minus 1. So here minus 1. So a means 5, d means minus 1. So minus of minus 1, plus 1. Here a means 5, d means minus 1, 5 plus 3 into minus 1. So 5, 3 minus 3 into minus 1 plus 3, 5 plus 3, 8. So 5 plus 1, 6. 5 minus 1, 4. 5 plus 3 into minus 1, minus 3, 5 minus 3, 2. Therefore, required 4 numbers are 8, 6, 4, 2 or 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay, next problem. Next question, find the sum of the following arithmetic progression. First question, 2, 6, 10, etc. up to 10 terms. Up to 10 terms. So here we want to find out sum of first 10 terms. So means here we want to find out Sn. Means sum of first 10 terms means we want S. 10 means here n is equal to 10. We know the formula to find out Sn is n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So S 10. 10 means n value 10. So first let us find out values of a and d using the given sequence. So a means first term. So d means common difference between any term and its previous term. So a means 2. So next d means second term minus first term. So 6 minus 2 is equal to 4. Up to n, we want to find out sum of n terms of the given sequence. So n means 10. We want sum of 10 terms. So yes, 10 is equal to question mark. So next write the formula. We know that Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Okay, here substitute we want S10. N means 10. 10 by 2 into 2 into a means 2 plus n means 10. 10 minus 1 means 9 into d means 4. Okay, next simplify. 10 by 2, 5. So 2 into 2, 4. 9 into 4, 36. So therefore 5 into 4 plus 36, 40. Therefore 5 into 40, 200. Therefore S10 is equal to 200. Means sum of first 10 terms of the given sequence 2, 6, 10 up to etc. is 200. Next problem. Next question. 3 by 2, 2, 5 by 2, etc. up to 18 terms. So here we want to find out sum of first 18 terms of the sequence 3 by 2, 2, 5 by 2, etc. So here also first let us find out the values of a and d. So a means 3 by 2 first term. So that is 3 by 2. D means second term minus first term. So 2 minus 3 by 2. So here subtract this term, find the LCM. LCM is 2, 2 into 2, 4 minus 3 by 2 into 2, 3. So 4 minus 3, 1, 1 by 2. Therefore, D is equal to 1 by 2. So N, N means number of terms. Here we want to find out sum of 18 terms. So therefore, N is equal to 18. We want Sn means S18. So we know that formula to find out sum of first N terms is Sn is equal to N by 2 into 2a plus N minus 1 into D. So we want S18. Therefore, S18 is equal to N. N means 18 by 2 into 2 into A. A means 3 by 2 plus N minus 1. So N means 18. 18 minus 1, 17 into D. D means 1 by 2. So simplify. 18 divided by 2, 9. Into here 2 to get cancels, 3 plus 17 into 1 by 2, 17 by 2. So 9 into, first add these two terms. So find the LCM for the denominators. 2 is the LCM, 2 into 3, 6 plus 17 by 2 into 2. 2 to get cancels, 17. So therefore 9 into 6 plus 17, 23 divided by 2. Next, this equal to 9 into 23 divided by 2 is 11.5. So 9 into 11.5 is 103.5. Therefore, S18 is equal to 103.5. Okay, next problem. Next problem, evaluate 3 plus 5 plus 7 up to 61. So evaluate means here we want to find out sum of these terms, is sum of 3 plus 5 plus 7 up to 61. So we know the formula to find out sum of n terms is Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So here first let us find out value of n. Here we know the value of a. A means first term is 3. So d means common difference between any term and it is previous term. So second term minus first term means 5 minus 3 is 2. So d is equal to 2. So here n means number of terms. Here we want to find out how many terms are there in this series. So first let us find the value of m. So using here observe, this is first term, second term. So 61 is the nth term. So if tn is equal to 16. So using this condition, first let us find out value of n. And then substituting the values of a, d and n, find the sum of these terms. Okay. So first let us find out value of n and a and d using the given series. So here a means 3. So d means 5 minus 3 is equal to 2. 61 is the nth term. Tn is equal to 61. So using this condition, first let us find out value of n. We want sum Sn. Okay. So consider the formula Tn. We know that Tn is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. So Tn means 61 is equal to, so a means 3, n minus 1 into d means 2. So first take this term into left side. 61 minus 3 is equal to n minus 1 into 2. 61 minus 3 is 58. 58 is equal to n minus 1 into 2. So take this term into left side, becomes divided by 2. So 58 divided by 2 is 20 9 is equal to n minus 1. Therefore, n is equal to, take this term into left side, 29 plus 1 is 30. Therefore, n is equal to 30. So, now let us find out Sn. So, using the formula, Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d, or we know the one more formula, a plus tn, because here we know the term tn. Therefore, consider formula n by 2 into a plus tn. Okay, or consider n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d, we get the same value. So, substitute here, n means 30 divided by 2 into a means 3 plus tn means 61. So, 30 divided by 2, 15. 15 into 3 plus 61, so 64. Therefore, Sn is equal to 15 into 64 is 960. Therefore, 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus up to 61 is equal to 960. Okay. We will continue in next class. Thank you.